that we have seen the Telugu trailer, we were waiting for it. So I just want to know first, when you see the Telugu trailer, after a long time you're seeing this, what was your reaction like? First reaction I want to see.
This trailer I have seen before. We have worked on it as well. So the voices and all, it's very different than, it sounds very different than the Hindi trailer, but we've made sure that the characters and the actors, their personalities are not lost. Even for my character, we tested at least 10 voices, and then that's how we got the voice. This girl who has done the voice for me is very good, and she's completely doing justice to the visuals. And largely, Vijender sir has worked on the trailer, and he's helped us with the language and everything. But it's very exciting. I always love the sound of Telugu a lot more. It's more empowering than Hindi, especially in a film of this nature. The way it rings is very, it's very cinematic, I feel. And I've seen Bahubali in Hindi and in Telugu for that reason, because it just rings so much more dramatic, I would say, as opposed to Hindi. So I'm very excited to see this.
Any dialogue you have managed to talk in Telugu? I know it is a tough for you. Vijender sir, would you like to one dialogue she can speak in Telugu of Manikarna, if possible?
Sir is saying to say Manikarnika. Manikarnika.
Yeah, Manikarnika. So, any Telugu dialogue? Any Telugu word have you tried?
You say, I will repeat after you.
Okay.
Excuse me. Next test Telugu dialogues in the movie. I'll make sure.
Okay, that's good. So, next voiceover will be, she will be learning Telugu.
Well, we would love to. Sir is writing my next film as well. Mm-hmm. So, we can have sir can have some Telugu connection where I can speak. Why not? Because in our films, we show a lot of Tamil and Telugu characters whose background is that. So why not?
Hi, madam.
Hello.
What made you become a director for this movie?
It was very accidental. I won't say that it was a very planned move. So the film was supposed to come in August first, and then we couldn't complete it till August, and Chris has committed to the other project, which is NTR, I guess. And then he went ahead with that, and he offered to do the remaining parts after Feb when he's done with this project. But we as a team felt that we needed to release it in Jan. So that was the decision taken almost like overnight. Initially it was a bit unsettling, but it became, because he had done a great job and I just had to sort of follow what he had done.
What you learned from this challenge or this opportunity,
Well, I just love how team sort of stood together, because it had to be done, and whether it is Vijender sir or the entire team, including Mr. Goenka and everyone, I felt that there was a lot of liking and a personal sort of ambition towards the film. Everyone had that, whether Shankar sir, everyone had a very sort of a personal, like sir's daughter's name is Manikarnika. I've been working for this film even before this team came on board, even with another team I was working. Even Mr. Goenka, he feels that this project has to be given the best. So I felt that the teamwork and how the team sort of stuck together and made it happen is what has been the most amazing experience.
Did you continue this journey as a director?
Yes, like I said, my next film, which I am directing, I have requested sir to write. So hopefully we'll start work on that soon.
Happy New Year, belated. I hope this year brings you a lot of success. Coming to your trailer, I've just seen you were just playing like a toy with the knife and the horse riding and all these things. How much time it took for you to learn all these things?
It took me a lot of time. I started with one sword, and then I had to do with two, and horse stunts, all of that. Around 2 months training it took, yeah.
Yeah. And what is the one thing you learned in your life with this film, especially with this? And what made you to choose this movie, or particularly this one?
I think there are a lot of heroes in our country who we've lost. And we've lost our culture, we've lost our history, and we don't show any responsibility or sensitivity towards that. So I feel that there are so many films come out of industry and we do not give any respect or tribute to the ones who've given their blood for us. And I think the ones who are in the film, the team, everyone in the film feels a sense of, you know, feel obliged to bring these stories to people through cinema. So I felt not just Rani Lakshmibai, there are so many uncelebrated, unsung heroes, especially from our country. So that was one reason. And besides her being so popular, it sort of makes for a very good brand name as well, because this is something you don't have to market much. Everyone knows about it.
First of all, congratulations, Kangana ji.
Thank you,
sir, for bringing Jhansi Lakshmi Bai's history to this generation. What is the toughest time or phase from script to first copy you faced?
There were many phases. I think the first phase was when my accident happened and I sort of, you know, broke my forehead. That was one. And second, when I had to turn director, and with the epic one, I remember when Kamal sir had come to me first with the script. He suggested that time that you should maybe direct, and I said, with this proportion, with the magnitude of the film, I wouldn't want to do it. But when I had to, I was a bit unsure about myself, that would I be able to do it, and I don't feel unsure about myself so often. So it was very difficult to deal with that phase.
All right, in the interest of time, we'll have the last question for Mr. Kamal Jain, if anybody. Anybody raising their hands, we'll pass on the mic. Yeah.
Hi, all of you. Mr. Kamal, what do you think, like a lot of biopics and...
Hi, this is Trisha. I'm Radhika Apte.
Vasan Krishnamurthy.
I'm Ali Mataratnanu.
You're watching E3 Media Network.
E3 Media Network.
E3 Media Network.
E3 Media Network. E3 means...
Entertainment.
Entertainment. Entertainment.